Thank you for that lovely introduction.
John, if you ask me, I think they're packed pretty tight in here tonight.
Oh my goodness, they are. I hope you all like each other, and I hope... When I get nervous, I get into this quasi-Jonathan Richman thing, so stop me if I do that.
You mean you jump into the audience?
How many people were here last night? Sounds like about 40 or 50. Do you know that record? No, you probably don't. So we have a bunch of songs. This one is the first song that we're going to play tonight.
And if we run out of songs, we're going to play it again later. It will be our last song.
Sensitive artist, I am a sensitive artist. I am a sensitive artist. I am a sensitive artist. Nobody understands me because I am so deep in my work. I make allusions to books nobody else has read, music nobody else has heard, and art nobody else has seen. I cannot help it because I am so much more intelligent and well-rounded than everybody in the whole fucking universe. I stopped watching television when I was 6 months old because it was pedestrian and stupid, and started reading books and going to recitals and art galleries. I don't go to recitals anymore because my hearing is too sensitive, and I don't go to art galleries anymore because there are people there and I cannot deal with people because they don't understand me. I stay home reading books that insult my intelligence and working on my work, which no one understands. I am sensitive.
I am sensitive.
I am sensitive.
Sensitive.
I am a sensitive artist. In junior high school, I had oily, stringy hair and lots of pimples. Most of the other kids called me a poofta. Even some of the other wusses called me a poofta. There were maybe 5 kids in the whole school who were wussier than I was. I was afraid of girls, and guys scared the fuck out of me. They used to say to me,
"Why are you fucking fruitcake?"
They wanted me to fight to prove I wasn't a poofta, but I didn't fight. I ran away. I was a wuss. I was never into any sports at all. I wore my gym clothes under my regular clothes so I wouldn't have to change in front of everybody else. I was afraid to realize my full potential in school because the other kids, the smarter you were, the wussier you were, and the wussier you were, the more they beat the shit out of you. I was a hopeless wuss. Wuss, wuss, wuss. I was into science fiction and math and chess. It was not fun being a wuss. And now that I like to think I'm not as much of a wuss as I once was, I still feel pretty wussy most of the time. Residual wussiness, kind of thing you can never really leave behind. That's the way it goes.
Wuss, wuss, wuss.
Oh, you know what? We should have put that one earlier in the set to shut this guy up. No, it's all right. I'm glad you're having a good time. And I hope we do nothing to change that, seriously. In order to remember your dreams, you must think of them as if they were little kittens. When you wake up in the morning, before you get out of bed, sit up and say, here, kitty, 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 here, kitty, 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 here, kitty, 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 here, kitty, 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 kitty. If this doesn't work, you must go into the kitchen and pour out a saucer of cream. Place it by the foot of the bed and say, here, kitty, 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 here, kitty, 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 here, kitty, 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 here, kitty, 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 here, kitty, 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 here, kitty, 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 here, kitty, 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 kitty. When the kitty gets the cream, it's just such a good groove. I want to just keep letting it go. When the kitty gets the cream, the dream is remembered. I personally did not hear enough Dog Bowl songs in the Dog Bowl set, so. So, you know, I mean, unfortunately, this one will be sung by me, but it's one of my favorites of his.
You sing it much better than me. It should have been a King Missile song.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Anastasia, would you like me if I sent you Russian blueberries wrapped in a box that cost me $1? Your name I wear on my doggy collar. Anastasia, you're from Eurasia, but Moscow, I'm sure, is where you belong. I would be forced to choose euthanasia if you say au revoir. I won't see you later. La 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 la. If I were a pigeon, would you be my seagull? We could chase the garbage boats at sea. And if my wings were broken, would you give me shelter? Cure my ills just like you cure my heart. La 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 la. La 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 la. Anastasia, is it absurd to dress like a dog and think like a bird? I mispronounce so many words except for the ones that tell you I'm yours. Anastasia, blueberries you give to me so generously, just like yourself, so sweet and sincerely. You know I love you more than dearly. La 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 la. If I were a pigeon, would you be my seagull? We could chase the garbage boats at sea. Oh, and if my wings were broken, would you give me shelter? Cure my ills just like you cure my heart. La 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 la. La la la. Anastasia, Anastasia, Anastasia.
There are many people I like in this audience. There are many people I adore in this audience. But this song goes to my favorite person anywhere. No, not you. She knows who she is.
One, two, three, four.
Because she likes this song, not because it's about her or anything, because it's not. She just happens to like this song a lot.
Once there was nothing but nothingness. But then something happened, and now there is somethingness. Now there is allness and smallness and tallness. Now there is roundness, profoundness and soundness, and silence and violence. And now there are trees, MP3s and disease. And now there is now. Now there is now. Now there is now. Nothing but nothingness. Then something happened, and now there is somethingness. And now there is allness and smallness and tallness. Now there is roundness, profoundness and soundness and silence and violence. Now there are trees, MP3s and disease. And now there is now. Now there is now. Now there is now.
The next five songs are all violent. They're all violent. We clumped almost all of the very violent songs right here. We're going to start with the first song from the first record. It's violent. It's sad.
It's violent, really?
At the end. He dies at the end. Oh, spoiler alert. He dies at the end.
It's also the opening track of the very first King Missile.
Wait, did you not hear me say that? I swear. Did I say that or did I not say that? Can't remember. I thought I said that.
I'm so deaf.
Could we have more of John and his monitor? No, I'm just kidding. You guys can hear me all right? You can hear them all right? Alex DeLazlo at the end there on the harmonica.
Searching for a harmonica.
R.B. Corbett.
Karen harmonica.
R.B. Yeah. Corbett played drums on the first record, but there she is playing bass because there was no bass on the first record. And instead of, you know, we needed two to replace her for so percussion, we've got Marlon Cherry. And Susan Wong. This is the Jong-Goo. And this is Lou.
We had a harmonica emergency, so thanks for the stage.
A har-emergency.
What happened?
I'm in a perpetual state of harmonica emergency. Not to worry.
All is well.
All right. One, two, three, four.
Lou wanted to be noticed and understood, but he was so quiet. So one day he wrote the following poem. A 4 or 5 piece band where 3 or 4 of the people don't play any instruments, performed in front of an audience consisting solely of 6'2" lesbians from Anchorage, Alaska, kind of healing, feeling friendly, sent for a fortnight and a half a ham and cheese, insinuating strenuous selfishness and culminating in concrete caribou tissue. After finishing the poem, Lou left it on the dining room table. And then he went into the bathroom, slid each wrist 7 times, quietly died. No one noticed, but everyone understood. No one noticed, but everyone understood.
This next song has 2 titles, actually. The official title, the love song. But then there's a song that people, when they ask me about this song, it's called Faces on the Wall.
Yeah, they call it Faces on the Wall. Yeah.
That's like the unofficial title.
And I always thought I should sing it the way I'm going to sing it tonight, which is really kind of more fucked up. It makes the song even more fucked. Is that all right with you guys? I don't sing it straight up.
Fucked up version.
Fucked up version.
1, 2.
It's a fucked up song. Faces on the wall, invisible faces on the walls, faces of criminals, faces of animals, faces all over the walls. They're telling me to cut up your corpse, telling me to slice up your face, telling me to paint in your blood. The faces all over the walls, they're telling me to paint in your blood, but I don't listen to them. No, I don't listen to them.
faces all over the walls. They're telling me to paint in your blood, but I don't listen to them. No, I don't listen to them. No, I don't listen to them. Because I love you.
I remember we were talking about this in rehearsal. When I showed the lyrics to this one to Dog Bowl, I was like, this one is just too fucked up. We can never do this one. And he was like, no, we must do this song. We must. Do you remember that?
Delicious.
That was like 47 years ago when I first showed you that song. Sounds like an exaggeration. Not even that much of an exaggeration.
Oh, wow, yeah.
It's like 47 days ago.
We must do this song, but it is fucked up. It's a fucked up song.
One, two, three, four.
It's called Farm. How delicious! The pig boy squealed as another rush of pure pain came over him. Then pig boy declared, this is what pig boy truly lives for. If only pig boy's eyes could be eaten by ants. If only pig boy could postpone joy permanently. If only pig boy could become bacon boy. Pig boy is tired of the struggle. Just then farm boy came in and chopped off pig boy's head. As farm boy ate the bacon, he began to feel queasy. Say, Ma, asked Farm Boy, are you sure this pork was prepared properly? Why, of course I'm sure, Junior, Ma quickly replied. Why would I want to poison my only child? Just then Farm Man came into the room, followed by the baby Jesus. I think you're evading the issue, Martha, the big burly man shouted accusingly, and I think it's about time somebody taught you a lesson. You tell him, Dad, said Farm Boy, who by this time was rolling on the floor in agony. Farm Man stomped the boy into the ground and went into the kitchen, lit the stove. He would have lit a cigarette, but he didn't have any. He had never smoked in his life, and this was no time to start. He stared coldly into Martha's understanding eyes. Farm Man began to weep, and he asked Martha if she'd like to go to a movie. They went to see Sallow. They liked it so much, they sat through it twice, completely forgetting the baby Jesus, who was accidentally locked in a broom closet and slowly suffocated.
Farm!
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 Two, three, four, farm!
One of the more fucked up songs that I've written. You wouldn't know it, most of you, maybe a couple of you. No, you wouldn't. I wrote it like in March. I was watching a lot of Stan Brakhage films, and I was writing poems about these Stan Brakhage films. And I kept thinking about this one film that I was gonna have to write something about eventually. The film is called The Act of Seeing with One's Own Eyes, which is the word autopsia is Greek for The Act of Seeing with One's Own Eyes. It's where we get our word autopsy from. So the movie is really just a silent film of like some autopsies. And I thought, wouldn't it be fun if I were one of the corpses being autopsied? You start this one. Almost alive, almost like it is still breathing. You look like
like you wanna look, but looks can be deceiving. Sometimes the heart doesn't know, and sometimes the heart lies. Sometimes the only thing you can rely on is the act of seeing with one's own eyes. There it is, lying there dead, and there is no pain. There was a cutting into the head and removal of the brain. Sometimes the heart doesn't say, and sometimes the heart lies. Sometimes the only thing you can rely on is the act of seeing with one's own eyes. The scalp is slit with a scalpel, and the face is removed. All is revealed as the skin is peeled off. Nothing else left to prove. With me, I can't move, I can't run, I can't hide. You can split me down the middle and see what's inside. Everything there is in me is here for you to analyze. Whatever you do, whatever you find should come as no surprise. Sometimes the heart doesn't say, and sometimes the heart lies. Sometimes the only thing you can rely on is the act of seeing with one's own eyes. Sometimes the heart doesn't know, and sometimes the heart lies. Sometimes the only thing you can rely on is the act of seeing with one's own eyes.
John, that's the first time I've ever listened to the lyrics of that song. That is really disturbing.
It is. It is. Well, you know, if you like that, go see the movie.
But you know what's also funny? Is that the next song is also
about
being open.
Yeah, as I was writing this song, I was like, well, this is kind of like a song from the They record, which we will do next.
One, two, three, four.
I am open. You can enter me, you can exit me, you never have to ask. I am open, open my head, cut into my head, take the lid off my head, empty out my head. Plunge your hands into my open hand. Take huge handfuls of head stuff. Make mud pies. Make a sculpture. Make a collage of blood and brains. Make sweetbread. Invite me to dinner. Enter me. Exit me. I'm open. I am enter me, you can exit me, you never have to ask,
you never have to ask,
cause I'm open, open my head, cut into my head, take the lid off my head, empty out my head, plunge your hands into my open head, take your headphones. exit me. I'm open. I'm open. You never have to ask.
Now, most of the rest of the songs are not quite so violent.
You're a vegetarian because the next song is kind of about meat.
I guess that's true. Yeah, yeah.
Ground
I wrote the lyrics before I was vegan, and you've never done this, have you? Have you ever done this?
I've never done this on stage.
She did it on the recording, but never on stage.
I think we did it once.
I'm very excited about this. I'm gonna go back there and watch.
One, two, three, four.
The heavy holy man sits on the hill holding hard wooden ball. Here's mysteries of the universe unfolding but blots it all out. He has one eye pointed towards the sky as the other searches over the earth for dinner. Without ever once leaving his hill, the heavy holy man has sampled fast food from all over Western Europe, wimpy burgers from London, Wonder Burgers from Dublin, and his favorite pit burgers from Paris, which he ate whenever he had some free time. This particular day, however, the heavy holy man traveled to Amsterdam, to Phoebo's, where he put 1.5 guilders in the slot, opened the little door, and pulled out his Phoebo burger and Phoebo napkin, all without ever leaving the hill. Then the heavy holy man smiled.
He smiled.
His faith reaffirmed once again. All the wonders of this or any other world are mine for the asking, he thought to himself.
From them, life is good.
I love E flat.
What?
I love E flat.
E flat, the chord?
Good ear, man.
Is Take Stuff From Work in E flat? I didn't know that.
I call it D sharp. He calls it E flat.
This one's in G, right? I'm learning music a little bit.
Regular G.
This next song is in G. It was written by none of us here on the stage.
And it's the best song.
But it is.
It is a cover.
But it is on our second record. So.
One, two, three, four.
Mr. Johnson lives on the corner of our street. He laughs at our bell-bottom trousers and our bare feet.
I'm gonna say poofdas again, okay?
And he called us long-haired poofdas as we walk by, but we never get mad, cause we know he's uptight. Hey, Mr. Johnson, won't you wear this flower in your hair? Then you start seeing love is all around you, everywhere. Love is all around you, everywhere. I've known Mr. Johnson since before I was born, but he still always gets mad when we smoke pot on his lawn. We never get mad, we simply walk away. He don't mean to be a drag, he's just brought up that way. Mr. Johnson, won't you wear this flower in your hair? Then you start seeing love is all around you, everywhere. Love is all around you, everywhere. Love is all around you, everywhere. Love is all around you, everywhere.
Dave Keener wrote that song. He wrote it for this ill-advised band I had called The Purple Sunshine. And that song, Open, on the Mystical record, is also from that band. And back in 1953, when we record... Oh, another violent song. And that might be the last... This might be the last violent song. Thank you for digging this one up, Jen.
She split my head open with a pickaxe, and I loved it. I loved every minute of it. She split my head open with a pickaxe, and I loved it. I loved every minute of it. Oh, and she tore my heart out of my chest. I asked for it, I begged for every minute of it. She tore my heart out of my chest. I asked for it, I begged for every minute of it. My eyes are open and bleeding. My mouth is full of dirt. For you, I would kill anything. For you, I would drown in blood. She split my head open with a pickaxe.
I fucked it up.
A pickaxe. And I loved it. I loved every minute of it. She tore my heart out of my chest. I loved it. I loved every minute of it. It's such a beautiful day. Such a marvelous morning of flowers and singing children. And I would fall into a sea of despair. An ocean of putrid, stinky, by disgusting hell. If you would kiss me once, if you would kill me once. If you would kiss me once and once again. And once and once and once again. At once. I loved it. I loved every minute of it. She's split my head open with a pickaxe. I left it. I'll tear my heart out of my chest. I asked for it, I'm dying for it. Split my head open with a pickaxe. I loved it, I loved it, I loved it.
One time. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's just do that.
He can't wait.
I woke up this morning with a bad hangover, and my penis was missing again. This happens all the time, it's detachable. This comes in handy a lot of the time. I can leave it home when I think it's gonna get me in trouble, or I can rent it out when I don't need it. But every now and then I go to a party, get drunk, and the next morning I can't for the life of me remember what I did with it. First I looked around my apartment, I couldn't find it, so I called up the place where the party was. They hadn't seen it either. I asked them to check the medicine cabinet, because for some reason I leave it there sometimes, but not this time. I told them if it pops up to let me know. I called a few people who were at the party, but they were no help either. I was starting to get desperate. I really don't like being without my penis for too long. It makes me feel like less of a man, and I really hate having to sit down every time I take a leak. After a few hours of searching the house and calling everybody I could think of, I was starting to get extremely depressed, so I went to the Kiev and ate breakfast. And then as I walked down 2nd Avenue towards St. Mark's Place, where all of those people sell yellow used books and other junk on the street, fuck me, I saw my penis lying on a blanket next to a broken toaster oven. Some guy was selling it. I had to buy it off him. He wanted $22, but I talked him down to $17. I took it home, washed it up, put it back on. I was happy again, complete. People sometimes say to me, well, that's an amusing little anecdote, but don't you think one of these days you ought to get that thing permanently attached? And I say, no, and I'll tell you why, because even though sometimes it is a pain in the ass, I like having a detachable penis. Detachable penis. Detachable penis.
Songs on Mystical that, you know, that you wrote music for, but this you wrote music for after Mystical came out, right? Okay.
Yeah,
all right.
We were touring.
Right.
I couldn't play.
Yeah.
So we made up something easier.
Quick question. Well, is there a Gary and Melissa in the house? Just want to make sure.
Go ahead.
If you are the Gary and Melissa.
We really need to know.
There seems to be this theory that Gary and Melissa is based on real people. Muffy was based on a real person, but Gary and Melissa was not, okay? As far as I know, unless
Gary
you know
Melissa
something I don't.
Is all of us. We are all Gary and Melissa.
May you all experience the Gary and Melissa.
So this is the alternative version of Gary and Melissa, and we hope that you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Gary and Melissa love to make love. Love to make love. Love to make love. Gary and Melissa love to make love. Love to make love. They love to make love.
Gary and Melissa love to make love. Love to make love. Love to make love to each other over and over and over again. For the first few weeks of their relationship, they made love 4 or 5 times a night. They were really turned on for a while. Then, to heighten their passion, they bought sex books. The Joy of Sex, the Kama Sutra, Joy of Sex Part 2, even yet still more Joy of Sex, Popular Mechanics, Betty Crocker, anything. They tried as many positions as they were capable of. Physically, 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 they were really turned on for a while. Then, to heighten their passion, they bought sex toys, Benoit balls, French ticklers, nipple clamps, cock rings, whips, chains, bondage gear, whatever. They set up a video camera, taped themselves having sex. This is before everyone had those phones, you know. Then they watched it on the VCR. You remember what a VCR? Then, to heighten their passion, Gary taped Melissa having sex with some of his friends, and Melissa recorded Gary having sex with some of her friends. Then they watched it on their gigantic television while having even more sex. As the years went by, Gary and Melissa became fine, upstanding members of their community. Although they never married, their relationship outlasted all of the marriages on their block, and they never fought except to heighten their passion. They had made an agreement that when one of them died, the other would continue to live with and make love to the corpse. But as luck would have it, they were both killed in a freak accident and died at the exact same moment, holding hands.
Gary and Melissa love to make love. Love to make love. Love to make love. Gary and Melissa love to make love. Love to make love. Love to make love.
Gary and Melissa love to make love. Love to make love, love to make love. Gary and Melissa, love to make love. Love to make love, love to make love.
One, two, three, four.
When I drive through the great Northwest, the snow caps on the mountaintops, the pack of wolves surrounds my truck, and my fingertips are so cold. All this beauty and all those wolves, they surround me with their eyes so blue. The mountains hide the wolves I love, and all I see is you. All I see is you. When I see you, I bleed like a hemophiliac of love. When I see you, I bleed like a hemophiliac of love. I remember the blood I bled and those wolf-like eyes upon your head. Lover, oh lover, you tear my flesh when the wolves are at my throat. And vapor is my breath in the cold Mack truck, surrounded by the wolves I love. I'll bleed for them like I will bleed for you. The never-ending stream of love. The never-ending stream of love. When I see you, I bleed like a hemophiliac of love. When I see you, I bleed like a hemophiliac of love. Oh, oh. Thank you.
hemophiliac of love. I see you, I bleed like a hemophiliac of love. When I see you, I bleed like a hemophiliac of love.
Yeah, that was another one of Dog Bowls. Love that song. Thank you so much for writing Hemophiliac of Love, Dog Bowl. I don't know where I would be if you had not written that song.
Probably in the top 40.
I saw a painting by Du Buffet today. I did. Yeah. I don't remember the name of it, but it was not this song. Yeah. I had a Du Buffet book, and one of the paintings was called Fluting on the Hump. And I was like, we must call the first record Fluting on the Hump.
And then none of us argue.
We had to write a song, of course.
That's
right.
One, two, three, four.
I can't relate to people who rush to catch the train. So much strain for such a temporary gain. Why not just once try to live a day in a leisurely way, like in that painting by Du Buffet? Fluting on the hump, on the hump, like a desert man taking a ride on a camel. Fluting on the hump, fluting on the hump, fluting on the hump, like a desert man taking a slow ride. Fluting on the hump. A desert man riding in the sand on a camel, fluting on the hump, fluting on the hump, fluting on the hump, like a desert man taking a slow ride, fluting on the hump, fluting on the hump.
Thanks. How many people came from out of town? A decent number of people came from out of town.
The king's of out of town.
You know, so Kendra over here was, with this label, going to maybe re-release some of the old Missile stuff. She said, I'm coming to town in September. And I said to Double, maybe we could do a show. And this is that show. So, yeah, it's all your fault. Thank you. And Kendra recently named a cat after this song.
One, two, three, four.
Muffy, she's an American original. Muffy, is she vegetable or mineral? Muffy, she lets it all hang out.
She lets it all hang out.
Muffy, funny and freckly Muffy. She'll sell you some memories, Muffy. She knows what it's all about.
She knows what it's all about.
Muffy, funny and freckly Muffy. She'll sell you some memories, Muffy. She knows what it's all about.
She knows what it's all about.
Hey, John, you wouldn't believe what I saw the other day.
No, well, why don't you tell me, Dogball?
Well, I was in the library, and I was on a computer, and I went to this website called Pornhub.
Pornhub?
Awesome. And, yeah, well, it was in the library. I never heard of this website before. But Pornhub is where they show a lot of dirty movies.
Dirty movies, really? Do tell.
Yeah, and there was a film with our old friend Muffy.
Muffy?
Dirty movie, yeah, man.
Muffy in a dirty movie?
Yeah, on
like
Pornhub.
A recent dirty movie? Of like G-MILFs or something? Or like, I don't. Like, because, you know, Muffy would have to be like in her like late 50s, at least. You know?
No.
I don't know. I think you're probably wrong, Dobo. I find it highly implausible that after all these
Josh,
years...
Josh, Susan, Marlon, Arby, Alex, it was our old friend Muffy.
No, come on, you gotta think about this. I really don't think it's possible. Seriously, you know, she's a well-established author. She lives in Los Angeles. She's,
You're right. There's no way she can meet her. I don't want to get sued, man.
Muffy, she's an American original, Muffy. Is she vegetable or mineral, Muffy? She lets it all hang out.
This one's about 2.5 years old. I used to use it, you know, in sets as a closing song, but this is not our closing song, okay? It kind of feels like a closing song, but there are several songs. The people up here can see the set list, and they'll tell you there's a few more songs. It's in F.
Regular F,
yeah.
I took that note earlier because I was going to forget.
John, I think this might be a violent song.
It's not for children, really. But, you know, if you are a child, you know what? Maybe you can appreciate it. Like, I would say that if you're a child, you might think that's a very juvenile song for an adult to sing. And I'll just say that, you know, you're not wrong. Oh, yeah, I should stand by here so you can hear the... Yeah, that's an F, roughly. And then there's a C, okay. All right, who starts this one? Not me. You?
And of course, you can hate fuck yourself. You can rub yourself raw until you chafe, until you bleed. And of course, you can hate fuck yourself. And of course, you can fuck yourself. Loving tenderness. isn't always so hot, I guess. You can cram things down your throat till you gag, till you choke, and of course you can hate fuck yourself.
Piano, we have Susan. If you were lame, Jesus would put his hands on you, of course, and he would have to go, I'm fucking it up. I've read the whole thing about the sugar into cocaine and vitamin pills and I'm going to start again. Fuck him. What time is it? Do we have time to start again? Because it's really sounding good. It was sounding so good, I was just like... Okay, here we go. Okay, wait. Let's just pretend like we're starting. Just pretend like this didn't happen. Jesus was way cool. Everybody loved Jesus. Everybody wanted to hang out with him. Anything he wanted to do, he would just do. He turned water into wine, and if he had wanted to, he could have turned oregano into marijuana, or sugar into cocaine, vitamin pills into amphetamines. He could have just looked you in the eyes, and you would instantly be automatically tripping. He walked on the water, swam on the land, he would tell these stories, people would listen. If you were blind or lame, you just went up to Jesus. Well, if you were lame, Jesus would have to go up to you, right? He would put his hands on you, and you would be healed. That is so cool. He could have played guitar better than Hendrix. He could have told the future. He could have baked the most delicious. You wouldn't fucking believe how good this cake in the world. He could have scored more goals than Wayne Gretzky. It's an old reference. Could have danced better than Baryshnikov. Jesus could have been funnier than any comedian. I don't even want to tell you what comedians he could be. Every comedian except Pryor, I would say. He was totally hardcore. He told people to eat his body and drink his blood. That is totally hardcore. But then some people got jealous of how cool he was, so they killed him. But then he rose from the dead. He rose from the dead, did a little dance, went up to heaven. I mean, that is so cool. Jesus was way cool. No wonder there are so many Christians. That was a good version. I like that version. I never thought of that thing about Pryor, but like, I rewatched one of the like, I think on Netflix they got like a Pryor. It's fucking amazing. Still fucking amazing. Pryor, man. Jesus Christ. I was watching that Richard Pryor special with Jesus, and Jesus was like, "Fuck me, that guy is so fucking." I could. My hat is off to you. He was like, John Hall. Jesus calls me John Hall. He's like, John Hall, thank you so much for introducing me to Richard Pryor. Can you believe I had never watched this? I'm pretty happy with that version. You got that one recorded, right?
A different song. 1, 2, 3, 4.
When she closed her eyes, she saw her planet explode. When she closed her eyes, she saw her head explode. Then she saw that her planet and her head were one. She saw everything when she closed her eyes. When she closed her eyes, she saw her planet explode. When she closed her eyes, she saw her head explode. And she saw that her planet and her head were one. She saw everything when she closed her eyes. Song. Thank you so much for coming. This is one of our classic closing songs. Thank you so much. We've had a lovely time. And you know what? I have to tell you, I have to apologize. They say when you're on stage, never apologize, but I always do. We did, you know, this is the thing I was saying to some people in the audience before the show. Cheesecake Truck is harder than it looks, and we didn't get it together. Maybe another time, but like, yeah, you know. But also the other thing about Cheesecake Truck is it's basically take stuff from work with cheesecakes, you know. So it's like, it kind of like, yeah, you know, but I like it too. I don't know what we'll do. But anyway, we're going to close with this one. you know, this is the way we'd like to end the set tonight, because the time is now, and now is, that's the end of the Modern Lovers Live record. Okay, let's do it.
World War
III? Oh, I forgot. Oh, we have two more. Yeah. Fuck me, we have two more.
Two more songs.
Yeah, I know, we're good. Yeah. Okay. Oh! Love this one. Cherry on the top like a nuclear warhead. Nuclear bomb gonna lick the trigger. I had a dog fly religion neutron on a chocolate sundae. Look, Mom, fallout is stuck between my teeth. Atomic toothpick picks the tartar. Clean it out like a yum, yum, yum. Then blow out my brains with a shotgun gun. I had a smile like old Jim Dandy. Radio, radio, active candy. Yum, yum, yum. Cherry on the top. Bop and beep and boop and bop. Gonna eat tons of snot. Then blow out my brains with a shotgun gun. Fun, 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 in the sun, sun, sun. Potato dog, dogs and flies. Real dull spoon will
pluck out my eyes.
Pluck out my eyes on Sunday. Blow out my brains on Tuesday.
Hey, 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 hey.
Is a giant ice cream cone. World War III is a giant ice cream cone. World War III is a giant ice cream cone. World War III is a giant ice cream cone. No more nukes, pluck out my eyes. No my eyes.
World War III, it is a giant ice cream cone.
World War III is a giant ice cream cone. World War III is a giant ice cream cone. World War III is a giant ice cream cone. World War III is a giant ice cream cone.
I'll apologize again for thinking that that was the last song, but there's one more song. Then we'll go back there. If you make enough noise, we'll come back. It's up to you. Not yet. All right, yeah, let's see. This one's called Martin Scorsese. He makes the best fucking films! He makes the best fucking films! If I ever meet him, I'm gonna grab his fucking neck and just shake him and say thank you for making such excellent fucking movies. Then I'm gonna twist his nose all the way the fuck around and rip off one of his ears and throw it like a fucking frisbee. I wanna chew his fucking lips off and grab his head and suck out one of his eyes and chew on it and spit out in his face and say thank you for making such excellent fucking films. Then I'm gonna pick him up by the hair, swing him over my head a few times, and throw him across the room and kick all his fucking teeth in and then stomp on his face 40 or 50
fucking times, cause he makes the best fucking films. He makes the best fucking films I've ever seen in my life. I fucking love him. I fucking love him.
Yesterday at the rehearsal, Dogwell said, I have this great idea for Martin Scorsese, but I don't think you'll like it. And I was like, I like it for a different song. Delicious juice. If only we could turn our heads into breads, we could slice ourselves up and make sandwiches. If only
sandwiches.
We could turn our heads into sandwiches. Leaves of lettuce hanging out in the salad bowl with tomato and carrots, some blue cheese dressing on top. That would be quite fine, I think. If only we could do that. If only. Turn our heads into any kind of food at all. It simply cannot be done. We must look elsewhere for answers. Much better. That is quite fine. That is quite precisely the quintessentially right number. I am extremely pleased. Thank you. And thank you, Martha, for the socks. You know, we were supposed to rehearse that backstage. I forgot. We both forgot. And then Martha gave me some socks before the show, and I was like, ah, fuck, I forgot. So, thank you. Thank you for the socks. I might wear them tomorrow. And we have, now, okay.
They are packed pretty tight in here tonight.
if anyone saw the very last King Missile show with, you were in that show, and me, and I think That was it, right? The rest of you guys were not in that show. We did a different song from this record, which is not one of our records, but this is from that record. Oh, fuck me, I left my water back there. Well, this is not going to come out very well. It's getting late now, have you seen my maid? My, tell me when the boys get here. It's 7 o'clock and I wanna ride, wanna get a belly full of beer. My old man is drunker than a bear full of monkeys, and my old lady, she don't care. My sister looks cute in her braces and boots, a handful of grease in her hair. So, don't give us none of your aggravation, we're hiding with your discipline. Saturday night's all right for fighting, get a little action in. Get up out as oiled as a diesel train, gonna set this dance alight. Cause Saturday night's the night I like. Saturday night's alright, alright, alright. Well, they're packed pretty tight in here tonight. I'm looking for a dollar, you see me alright. I may use a little muscle to get what I need. I may sink a little drink and shout out, she's a man! Couple of the sounds that I really like are the sounds of a switchblade and a motorbike. I'm a juvenile product of the working class, whose best friend floats in the bottom of the glass. Oh, don't give us none of your aggravation, we had it with your discipline. Saturday night's alright, alright, alright. Ooh, 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 ooh. Here we go. Susan Wong, Alex DeLaszlo, R.B. Corbett, Marlon Cherry, Dog Bull,
John S. Hall.
Thank you so much. You've been very, very wonderful and patient. We really appreciate it.
We're very patient.
Namaste.